Hello, Mercedes lovers. The time has come for a transmission job. My car has about 170,000 and finally the reverse gave up. It's been coming for a while, so I was putting it off, checking, because I had other projects, so finally my reverse wouldn't engage anymore. So a little history. So my all the forward gears work fine. There's a little bit of well, I wouldn't say it harsh, but you feel once in a while a very light bump from it shifting from first gear to a second. And the reverse was always a little bit sluggish. When you put the car in reverse, I would hear a little hissing sound, and then after a second and a half, the reverse would engage and it would drive fine. It wasn't sleeping or anything. Lately, for about probably three weeks ago, I noticed that if I put the car in reverse, it would still drive, but it wouldn't have like a positive engagement. If I press a little bit of a gas, then I would get a little kind of a bump. The reverse would engage and the car would drive in reverse fine. And it wasn't sleeping or anything. So, like I said, last week, and finally driving from work, I stopped on a little of an incline and trying to go in reverse. The reverse wouldn't engage. The car still managed to kind of pull in reverse a little bit, just enough so I can pull forward and get out of the parking spot. And I decided to park the car and pull the transmission off and find out what the problem is. So I guess the next couple of videos is gonna be dedicated to a transmission removal, disassembly, inspection, and hopefully it's going to be an assembly as well and testing at the end. So should be an interesting project. Well, let's start. And as always, the first thing is when you're doing any major job like that is disconnect the battery. So as you know, 202 chassis, the battery is located in the trunk. So you go there and 13 millimeter wrench, disconnect the negative cable and pull it off the battery. So now you don't have any electricity in the car and you can work safer.
So the first thing here, we need to loosen up the bracket that holds the transmission dipstick tube. So there's a little cap screw with a socket head. So in order to get there, I want to pull this the air duct, and to give me a little bit more access to
the
area.
In order to pull the air duct, first we need to loosen up the clamp. It's a 7 millimeter socket with a long extension. We can reach over . Loosen that clamp. Disconnect the MAF sensor. Pull the two clips off. This one's coming loose though. And then we remove two nuts on top. Disconnect the temperature sensor plug. And this thing's coming off. Just place it over here. Now we have access to that screw. So a 6mm Allen key, we should be able to get in there.
So as you can see, this is a little bit of a tight spot. So in order to reach and take the bolt out, you're gonna need a wrench, something like that, that a 6mm bit fits in. Has to be fairly short in order to get there. You see, you need to get in there in order to remove that screw.
So next, we need to drain the oil from the transmission and the torque converter. Now, in order to drain the oil from torque converter, you need to line up the drain screw with the opening in the housing. And in order to do that, we need to spin the crankshaft to the right position. And in order to do that, to gain access to the crankshaft, we need to remove this the fan shroud. So to remove the fan shroud, first you pull this clip back, then you take the inner piece closest to the engine and you spin it in a clockwise direction to disengage it. You pull it back and you leave it on top of the fan. The piece that's closest or furthest from the engine has two clips over here. So one is here and one is here. You remove the two clips, you pull the hose back. Now you can pull this piece of a shroud slowly and it comes out. So after you've done this, don't really need to, but probably better if you remove the piece that closest to the engine. Just free it from the fan and you pull it out. So now you're free to get to the crankshaft.
So in order to line up the drain plug with the opening, you're gonna have to position yourself in such a way that you can still see the opening. Same time, you want to be able, and this picture is upside down, come on, focus. Well, same time, be able to reach the wrench, and you're gonna spin the crankshaft in this direction. And my camera for some reason doesn't want to focus. So as you're turning the crankshaft, you watch this location, and as soon as the drain plug lined up, that's it. So now you can take a hex key or Allen key and open up the drain plug on a torque converter and same time drain it on the transmission. So here we go. Remove the two plugs and let the torque converter drain. And down here you see there's a pan, oil pan, and there's a transmission draining. So I'll let them drain and then I'm gonna check the oil. I did change the oil about I guess 40,000 or about 50,000 kilometers ago. That was what, 2 years? So that would be interesting to see, because on a dipstick the oil smelled okay and the color was okay. So we'll see how the oil looks like. So next step, we need to separate the torque converter from the engine. So in order to do that, we need to pull this cover off, which I already did. And inside there, you're gonna see there's gonna be 6 bolts. So I already removed this one, so it's a 13mm head. And you take the bolts out and you keep spinning until you get all 6 bolts out. Now, just in case, I guess I'm gonna take and I'm gonna put a mark, so when I assemble it, I'm gonna mark this and I'm gonna mark the flywheel and the torque converter, I guess, kind of like that, just in case if the thing doesn't want to is possible to install in different different locations, but I prefer to install it the same way as it was. So I'll take the bolts out and I'll see you back.
Well,
guys,
I got the six bolts out.
I suggest you guys buy a box of Ziploc bags, the small ones, right where the bolts are come from, and put them in the bag. This way, later on, you won't have any questions where the hell the bolts are coming from. Also, if you're gonna have tough time turning the engine, because you need to turn the engine in order to take those six bolts, because they go all around. So you might want to pull the spark plugs out, because the compression in the engine has some resistance. So if you pull the spark plugs, you won't have any compression, and the crankshaft is just going to be much easier to spin.
All right, guys. So next, we need to remove this crossbar. Now, this is the two bolts that have the rear transmission mount attached. So obviously, when you're going to drop this crossbar, the transmission is going to drop down. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to use a small jack, and I'm just going to support this transmission just a little bit. Don't, no pressure, no nothing, just a little bit of support. So when I drop this piece, I it doesn't drop down. So first, I'm gonna take the two bolts that are holding the mount, and then you see there's two bolts on this side, and there are two bolts on this side. Can't remember what size are they, but you can figure out. So yeah, take the two bolts first, and then this ones, and that piece should come off. And then after that, you can I'm gonna remove the rear transmission mount. All right, so 13 millimeter socket for the transmission mount bolts, and 17 millimeters for the four bolts holding the cross bar. Next, we need to remove the exhaust bracket. So you see there's two bolts under the transmission, and there are two nuts on the other side of this from behind. So these are all 13 millimeters. So, and I need to take this bracket off. All right, next step. So we need to disconnect the flex coupling, and only need to disconnect the three bolts is that one that attaches the flex coupling to the flange on the transmission. Now, might be able to get through this side. If not, might need to take off the transmission mount, just gonna give me a little bit more room. So probably I'm gonna first take off the transmission mount. Okay, so for the transmission mount, there's two screw bolts on each side over here, and those are 15 millimeters. All right, so transmission mount, you can see that this bolts are a little bit offset, so that's the front towards the transmission, and that's to the back. So I'm just gonna do this, and I'm gonna put a little arrow and call it to the front. Now that transmission's mount out of the way, we have lots of room to work and take those bolts out. In order to turn the drive shaft, You can put the transmission in neutral. This way you'll be able to spin the flange to get to all three bolts. And to remove the bolts, you're gonna need two 19 millimeter wrenches. Better if they are closed end, like this, or you have if you have the ones that are actually spinning, but the two wrenches should work just fine. So pay attention, because the washer in this case goes on this side, not on that side, but on the side, goes under the head of the bolt. And now that the car is in neutral, I can rotate the drive shaft to get to other two bolts. And before you take the last bolt out, you want to mark the location on the flange and mark the drive shaft. Where's my mark? You see the yellow mark? So when you're going to reinstall that, you have to reinstall in that same orientation. So next, need to drop down the exhaust. So for that, there's one mount over here, and see, there's one mount over there, and another one just before the diff on the left hand side. You see that bracket on the exhaust right here. So in order to drop it down, I also need to disconnect it from the manifold. Now the reason also that I wanted to drop it down, because I wanted to change the oxygen sensor, the upstream one. So disconnecting from the manifold was a bit tough. So I ended up pulling the exhaust manifold, the front section over here, and I had to hammer a bit in order to disconnect it over here. So now the exhaust is loose. And the next step is going to be, we need to access the drive shaft clamping nut. So we need to loosen the clamping nuts to be able to slide the drive shaft to the back to make more room for the transmission to get pulled back. So here we need to disconnect the Bowden cable, and that's the one, if you can see, this is the accelerator cable right here, that in the front, and behind it, it's hard to see, it's so-called the Bowden cable. So to gain some more access, I'm gonna take off that window washer fluid reservoir, and then see if I can access it from here. So to take this off, you just need to remove this nut, actually a screw, and you just, it's gonna be loose, so you just pull it up and place it on top of that. Now we need to disconnect the transmission pressure control cable, or otherwise known as a Bowden cable, or otherwise known as the kickdown cable. So taking this cable, or disconnecting, let me show you guys. So the end of the cable, as you can see, that's the end of the cable. It just snaps in onto this, the arm. Let's see if I can put, so it's really tight in here, so just hang with me. So this arm, if you see on the other end, you can probably see right here, down there, you can see the little ball. So that end of the cable just snaps onto that ball. And this bracket over here So you need to squeeze that square piece, squeeze it from the top and from the bottom. So when you squeeze it, then you can push it out, and this way you can disconnect this cable. So before disconnecting or pushing out, I'm just gonna mark the top. I'm gonna put a yellow dot on it. Okay, now to push that square piece out, a pair of pliers like that works really good. So I'm gonna reach in, place it in here, squeeze it, and push it out. Okay, now I can just pull the cable through and it's gonna be free. So now need to gain access to the drive shaft. I guess there's a center nut, because we need to slide this drive shaft back and drop it down so we have clearance to pull the transmission back. So I guess I'm gonna be removing this heat shield. So there's this M8 nuts, there's about four of them. Just take them off and remove the heat shield. Also, probably I'm gonna remove this kind of a security bar. That's pretty much just is there to hold the drive shaft if it disconnects from the transmission. And also there's another security bar you see over here. So I'm not sure about this one, if I need to drop it down as well, but the front one for sure. So need to the heat shield and that bar. So where's this review with the heat shield removed? So here's the steady bearing. This is the nut. Comes down. So that's still the bracket I need to remove. So guys, after thinking for a minute, I decided to drop the drive shaft completely, just because when I lowered the front, I didn't like the angle that it created in here on the steady bearing rubber. So I just taken the rear crossbar and taken the three bolts off the rear flexible flange. So now all I need to do is just pull that forward, which is disconnected from the flange in the back, and drop the whole thing down and have it away of the way, sorry, not away, having out of the way. I think it's gonna be much easier. So next need to disconnect the kickdown solenoid cable. So it's this one. In order to disconnect, just pull on this connector, goes in here. So just pulling it, and eventually it would get out. So that's the kickdown solenoid. So next, we need to disconnect the shift rod. Now there are two connections, one over here. This is under where your shift lever is, and or shift or gear selector, I would say. Now there's a similar connection up there in the front. Let's see if you can see it, but it looks like it's quite hard to get to that one. So I think I'm gonna be disconnected it from here. Now this thing comes off real easy. Just need to pull on this clip. You need to press on it and then pull to disconnect, and then this shaft comes out. All right, let's disconnect it from here. So next, we need to pull this plug off. Where is it? Okay, we need to pull this plug off. So, to disconnect this plug, what you need to do, you need to push on this white lever all the way up, and then this plug comes out. Funny enough, my plug had this lever for some reason in an up position, so that's quite interesting. Anyway, let's move along. So next, after we move from this connector, we move along and we get to this one. So I think this is a starter lockup switch. So in order to pull this out, you see there's a circlip or like a little ring. So what you need to get a small screwdriver or like a pick and basically pick up this circlip and place it, just basically take it out of the groove and place it on the side, and then you'll be able to pull this connector out. And just after that, just place it back. So I guess when you're gonna reconnect it, you just plug it in and the circlip will lock it in place. All right, next. So here, I guess we need to pull this clip out so we can just free the cables. Now this is done from the back side. You just squeeze the tabs, so this is free. Now, where the transmission ends, now we need to disconnect this. I guess that's a ground cable. So let's do that. So I've taken this bolt out, so the cable is free now. I've taken this bolt out as well. So both of them are 17 millimeters. So now I can take the two lines that run to the oil cooler. So careful, you need to have a collection pan because there's oil in these lines and oil in the oil cooler. So I'm gonna put a pan and drain both lines. All right, so disconnecting the oil lines. Let me put this. So we disconnect this side over here. It's a little bit leaking, so it's an M17 millimeter. Then there's a 5 millimeter socket head. Just a little screw over there, just to loosen it up. The other side, so same thing. There's a 17 millimeter over here. Let me bring the light. Okay, so a 17 millimeter there. There's a little screw over here, a 5 millimeter. And there's a little screw over here. Where is it? Oh, right there. So now this oil cooling lines are free. So I've started taking the transmission bolts out. So the ones that I can access from the bottom. So this one's all pretty much same length. The one by the starter, see, it's this long one. So it came from that hole. You see, I marked it with a yellow X. Now, need to unbolt this rear panel so we have more room to lower the engine. So first, we remove this pin from this location. Second, there's a pin holding this plastic. It's in this location over here. then this piece just pulls out. It's loose. Okay, then pull this pin from this location. Next, need to pull this cable out to free it. And now there are two screws here, one screw over there, and another screw you see over here. So need to remove them. So there's actually two screws on this side, one is hiding over here. So, just to recapture this rear panel. So, first, remove the clips. Second, you can pull this, the cover, whatever, the isolation or noise protection. You're gonna have to take some scissors and cut a slot in here, because it won't go out. So after you've done this, you're gonna see there's four screws, two on this side, M8 heads, and two on this side. After that, there's two 10 millimeter, two screws with a 10 millimeter head. One is here, and one is behind over here. So now, this panel is loose, and I want to see, I don't think I can remove it, but at least I can pull it out on this end, and careful about this plastic piece, because there's a slot so it sits in this plate. So now I disconnected the vacuum line on the modulator valve. It's the black line over here, and I'm gonna put a tag on it. Also, there's a green line over here running to this valve. So I'm just gonna pull this off. Okay. So it's coming. And what else is here? I think that's it. Now this is, I think it's a cable. That's a white cable running over here. So there's a second long bolt that comes on top of the starter. So far I got two long bolts, one under the starter and one on top. Все, и просто снимай.
Okay.
Такое. Подставляй.
магнита нету, да?
Магнита нету.
Ну, сейчас оно все в другую сторону уже.
Фильтр. Ну, видишь, смотри, сколько говна. О, то есть я, когда наливал, когда масло менял, я это все чистил. Да.
Well, guys, the transmission's out. And I think it was the right decision to pull it out and just have a look, and I guess I need a rebuild because there's a lot of friction material I can see on the pan. And this transmission, I did change the oil about 40,000 kilometers ago, and at this time it was full also of that friction material. So I'm just gonna take you guys back and a few pointers on pulling the transmission out. So main things, the tools that you're gonna need. You're gonna need lots of extensions. I use the half inch. So you're gonna have to reach to the bolts that are on top, because those are the hardest to reach, and you're gonna need lots of extensions. Also, you will need a help, so from another body, because it's quite difficult to line up the socket with the bolts. So it's better if you have somebody who knows what he's doing, which I mean technically inclined. Now, on the engine, I did end up pulling the exhaust manifold completely, both sides. It just makes it a little bit easier to access the bolts that are over here, like on top. At least you can see what you're doing. Before you can reach this bolt over here, you're gonna need to pull the dipstick tube out, and this is a bolt that's higher. So, like I said, you need another body as you're pushing the extension with the socket, and you need somebody to line up that socket with the bolt. And also, what you're gonna need, you're gonna need one of this, I just don't see it, but it's a half inch swivel like that, because you cannot access the head of the bolt straight, so you do need a U-joint like that. Also, before pulling the transmission, you're gonna need to support the engine in the front. So I have this jack, and I jacked it on the front, because when you're gonna pull the transmission out, the front of the engine is gonna get heavy and gonna tend to go down. And if you don't support it, you're probably gonna damage the fan, because on this car, as you can see, the fan is really close to the radiator. Okay, another pointer. In order to pull the transmission, have some cardboard, because you're gonna have to slide the transmission on a cardboard. Also, if you have, you're gonna need a motorcycle jack. Something like that, which has a flat top, and this works really good when you're placing the transmission on top, and you can go up and down, and this one's pretty low profile, and it keeps the transmission stable, so it's not rocking. All right, the other pointer, the kickdown cable. So I didn't pull it completely, but I ended up removing the thing from the transmission. So you just give it a twist and you pull it up. This way you don't need to pull the whole cable out. So I think that's pretty much it, guys. Now, I guess I just want to mention again that most of the bolts, and I'm gonna count them how many, are same links except the two that are around the starter. So like I said, the total number of bolts is 10 on the transmission. Two of these are long ones, these are the ones around the starter, and all the rest, there's 8 shorter ones. These ones, there's 2 bolts that go on the cooler lines. This has 2 washers, so you installing the cooler lines, you need to replace these washers. Now another pointer, as you're pulling the transmission back, watch the torque converter, because like in my case, the torque converter tried to stay with the engine and it's quite heavy. So take a screwdriver and just pry it off the engine. You want the torque converter to come with your transmission. Don't leave it hanging in the engine, because if it falls, it's quite heavy, you might damage it. Another consideration is the height of the vehicle. As you see, guys, I have my car to the bottom of this. It's 12.5 plus 3.5, so that's 16 inches. Now, 16 inches, that's, I think it's a minimum that you should have your car up, because I just barely squeezed the transmission out. I had to put it on the floor, have it on a piece of cardboard, and then the front of the transmission, I had to slide it over here. So the higher you put the car, the easier it's going to be to work. But you might consider something more solid than the jack stands. Maybe build the ramp and place them under the tires. So probably it's going to feel a little bit more solid than the car jacks. Because, like I said, I adapted regular car jacks or regular jack stands. I had some hockey pucks on top. I would prefer to have something round that is more solid and make sure it doesn't slide off. Anyway, the point I wanted to make is 16 inches, that's probably the bare minimum you want to have your car up. So that's pretty much it for the transmission removal. And stay tuned, guys. It's going to be a video on transmission disassembly and inspection. So that's going to be probably in a few weeks. Thanks for watching.
Well, here you go, guys. You just watched a transmission being removed from the 1995 C280 in a W202 chassis. Now, what I wanted to say, is it a hard job? Probably yes. On a scale to 10, I would probably rate it somewhere 9, 8, maybe 10, somewhere in this area. You can see the manual for the shop, and I mean a transmission shop, has about 7 hours for removal and installation of the transmission. Probably they can do it in that time, because they do have the lift, so you don't need to crawl under the car every single time when you're looking for the right wrench, for the right socket, every time you have to get in and out. They also more, I guess, experienced, I was doing this the first time. I've never removed the transmission from a vehicle yet, so that's my first experience. And I can tell that took me about 2 days to remove the transmission. Now, giving not the 2 full days, but probably about, I would say maybe about 12 hours altogether, so 6 hours a day. Is it doable for DUI guy? Probably yes, I can tell, but it's not the easiest job. So if you're planning to do that and you have never done a transmission removal, it's probably the best idea to leave the beer alone, and you can have the beer to celebrate when your transmission's out of the car. And you'll see in the videos, I did not film every little step that I've done, because it's kind of impossible to hold the camera with one hand and turn the wrench with another one. So I guess you guys have to excuse me for that. But I did try and capture every step in removing that transmission. So I was just trying to see and gauge if the transmission shop actually overcharges for that job. So far, I think removal installation 7 hours, that's quite right. So I don't think I'm gonna dispute that. The next step is gonna be disassembly, inspection and assembly, and a transmission shop to rebuild this transmission on the bench. They quote usually about 20-21 hours, so you can calculate how much that will cost. And probably this is why, if you take this transmission to a shop, they usually quote about $3,000-$3,500 to be rebuilt. So I would say mostly, I guess this video is done for entertainment purposes. So if you're planning to do it yourself, I'm not responsible and I'm not liable for any mistakes that you make. And thanks for watching.